Audible Inc. presents Small Business, Big Vision. Lessons on how to dominate your market from self-made entrepreneurs who did it right. Written by Adam Toren and Matthew Toren. Narrated by Fleet Cooper. Introduction. Why you need this audiobook and why you need a big vision. It's no secret that there are a million business books out there. Almost anything you could ever wonder or want to learn about business is contained in a book somewhere, and you can track down anything that's not in one of those many books online. Doesn't sound like we're making a great case for listening to this audiobook, does it? Yet the truth is that although we've read a great number of books and are constantly reading blogs and other online sources, there still seems to be something missing to us. Sure, there are plenty of interviews with successful entrepreneurs all over the place. There are more than enough opinions about what you should and shouldn't do when starting and running a business. And there is even some helpful how-to style information here and there for a price. What's missing, as far as we can tell, is an approach that provides you with the information you need, explains how to implement that information, and also gives you some concrete examples of people who have applied the techniques presented successfully. And that's why you need this audiobook. We are not just presenting theories and feel-good stories about millionaire entrepreneurs. Instead, we're providing you with real value, information you can implement in your own company, whether you're in pre-startup mode or already thriving and growing. We're also giving you real-life examples of other entrepreneurs who have used the same methods to start and grow amazing businesses. These examples will show you that it's not only possible to use the information we've presented, but exactly how others have done so. Throughout the audiobook, we also focus on the importance of vision in building your business. Why is vision so critical? Regardless of the quality of the information you receive from other sources, and regardless of how inspiring you find the examples you listen to, if you don't maintain your vision for what you want your company to become, it's not likely to happen. Each entrepreneur we profile will substantiate that his or her unwavering belief is the single factor that has made all the difference in their success. Some of the people we've profiled have college degrees, and some don't. Some came from entrepreneurial backgrounds, and others didn't. A few of our entrepreneurs had a decent amount of startup capital, while many scrimped, scraped, and bootstrapped their way to success. But one thing is common to each of them, and to every entrepreneur on the planet. Every single person who launches and develops a business faces obstacles and challenges along the way. Period. There are no exceptions. You, too, will come up against opposition in many forms, often even from within your own head. And all the tricks, tools, and action steps in the world, no matter how sound they may be, won't help you one bit if you don't have the right outlook and a strong, clear vision. Your vision is what solidifies your resolve when things get tough. And it's what clarifies exactly why you want to be in business in the first place. And having a big vision from the beginning is what makes it possible for you to know when you've finally made it. After all, your vision is all about knowing where you're headed. Without it, how will you know when you get there? Of course, many people will tell you that there is really no such thing as getting there. And there's some truth to the fact that the most successful entrepreneurs in the world often never really feel as though they're done. True entrepreneurs don't relish the destination as much as the thrill of the journey. However, that doesn't change the need for vision, because vision is fluid. Having a clear picture of where you want to go isn't about laying down a rigid path from which you never waver. It's about knowing what you want and knowing that you'll do whatever it takes to get it. The what you want part might change, grow, or even morph into something completely different over time. But as long as it always represents what you truly want, you'll know that you are on the right track. There is a significant difference between people who change their goals based on new information or desires, and people who are all over the place because they just don't know what they want. And that difference is vision. Our story. We have no interest in writing an autobiography at this point in our lives. An audiobook that's all about us would be contrary to what we're trying to achieve. So that's not what we've put together here. However, we do recognize that you might not have ever heard of us and probably want to know a little about who's delivering the advice in this audiobook. So here is our story, in a nutshell. We grew up learning the entrepreneurial lifestyle from our grandfather, Joe. He actually set us up on our first entrepreneurial venture, selling little stunt airplanes at a local folk festival. He taught us the proper way to use the stunt plane to really wow the audience, and we sold out of them before the folk festival was over. What a great feeling for a couple of 7 and 8-year-old kids. So it began. The entrepreneurial bug had taken its bite. We went from one mini venture to the next throughout our school years, from importing stereo equipment to magic kits from Hong Kong. We learned a lot and made some money along the way. As soon as we graduated from high school, we took the money we had earned and bought a struggling billiard hall in an up-and-coming part of our town. This is where we learned the saying that you hear so often from entrepreneurs. We poured our blood, sweat, and tears into that business. We put in many long hours, undertook a huge rebranding, and devised a number of creative promotions for the venue. We eventually expanded it into a place where people can enjoy a game of pool and a nice glass of wine while listening to a live jazz band on stage. Our hard work, dedication, and creative marketing ideas allowed us to soon become the place to be on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday evening, and we had lines at the door nearly every night. The buzz about this cool, new night spot continued building. We then started throwing private parties for the movie industry, as we had the ideal location and a big enough space to accommodate large groups. The steady stream of nightly customers, coupled with the corporate business we were able to attract, equaled success beyond anything we had imagined. Before we ended our first year in business, we had received an offer to sell. It didn't take long for us to realize that the long nights of sleeping on our venue's couches had paid off. We took the deal and moved on to our next adventure. This time in a totally different industry about which we knew nothing, printing and graphics. We found a struggling downtown printing and graphics company, and we used the same philosophies and ethics to overhaul and brand that organization. Success came quickly again, as we sold it on our 11th month in business for a sizable profit. We took our graphic team from the printing company with us and then launched a publishing and media company, which has been one of our main focuses for the past 5 years. We have owned and operated several niche market luxury lifestyle magazines in Canada, Arizona, and California. With a combined readership of more than 500,000 per issue, our venture in the publishing business has remained strong even while others in this sector have struggled. We realize that some things haven't changed much since our first business venture. Our passion to help others launch, manage, and grow successful business ventures started early, continued throughout our early entrepreneurial lives, and drives us to this day. While we were working hard on some of our first business ventures early on, we were written up in several media outlets. The Junior Achievement Association took notice of this and asked if we would be willing to speak to a local high school's 11th and 12th grade marketing and entrepreneurship classes about our experiences. As a result, we gladly began speaking to students on a regular basis, We were thrilled to share our stories and regularly dedicated a few days every month to visiting community high schools and talking about the real-world entrepreneurship experiences we've had. It provides these students with a nice break from their textbooks, because it's always powerful to hear real stories from people who are actually living these lessons. This rewarding experience compelled us to want to help as many entrepreneurs as possible. In 1999, we set out to build what has now become the largest and fastest-growing social networking forum for entrepreneurs in the world, youngentrepreneur.com. Young Entrepreneur has since become a must-visit resource for startup CEOs, founders, aspiring entrepreneurs, mentors, and investors worldwide. It reaches an audience that few other websites can match. This model caused us to realize the great need for quality entrepreneurial resources. As a result, we began selfmade.net earlier this year. Our social network and blog properties also include blogtrepreneur.com, which is dedicated to helping online entrepreneurs find success. The site showcases information on entrepreneurship, marketing, online business strategies, as well as interviews with entrepreneurs and a wide range of features, solutions, and support. We also help small business owners from a wide variety of industries start, run, grow, and even sell their businesses through our consulting firm, Biz Warriors. One of our specialties is improving profitability of underperforming businesses with a unique bottom-line approach. Our consulting work also allows us to provide instruction in management concepts and finance to emerging and distressed small businesses, covering all phases of operations. In short, almost all of our efforts now are designed to assist small business owners with starting, managing, and growing successful business ventures. One thing we've learned through all of our entrepreneurial adventures is that good advice is priceless. And that's precisely why we wanted to write this audiobook. It is our mission to help entrepreneurs succeed. And in what follows, we will do our best to fulfill that mission. We've had many mentors and teachers along the way, and we hope we can do for you what they have done for us. Provide the insight and knowledge necessary to make your entrepreneurial dreams a reality. Chapter 1. The Importance of Having Big Vision. Good business leaders create a vision, articulate the vision, passionately own the vision, and relentlessly drive it to completion. Jack Welch. Entrepreneurs come from every conceivable background, every ethnic group, economic class, education level, and physical ability. Almost every age group, and both genders. Some come from generations of business owners, while others are the first in their families to ever consider starting their own business. Among the ranks of those who call themselves entrepreneurs are inventors, programmers, and artists, while others excel at building teams, selling, or devising marketing plans. It is difficult to come up with a description of what a common entrepreneur looks like or acts like, or to pinpoint the necessary skills or experience one must have. In fact, there is an endless list of differences among entrepreneurs, but there is one thing all entrepreneurs have in common: vision. Why is vision a universal entrepreneurial trait? It is because the purest definition of an entrepreneur is someone who starts a business with a great deal of initiative and potential risk. These individuals' willingness and desire to take that initiative and assume that risk sets them apart from everyone else in the world. Every entrepreneur has experienced this feeling. Sometimes it's a spark that springs to life while brainstorming with a business associate. Other times it's a surge of inspiration while in the shower, or that aha moment that wakes you from a sound sleep. It's the first glimpse into the very essence of possibility, and the feeling is indescribable. Some people have even called it spiritual. The feeling takes hold the moment you sense that you're onto something amazing, and ignites when you realize it could be something huge. That realization, that picture in your mind of future possibilities, is what vision is all about. It's something on which you can expand to take your business from a mere inkling of an idea to a full-fledged, fully operational, thriving company. That's the feeling that overtook Dan Chaubel when he first imagined what his company, Millennial Branding, could become. Entrepreneurial Profile. Dan Chaubel of Millennial Branding, LLC. To say that Dan understands what it's like to have a big vision is quite an understatement. At 27 years old, Dan is the youngest columnist at Businessweek and has been called a personal branding guru by the New York Times. He is the managing partner of Millennial Branding and the author of the number one international best-selling career book, Me 2.0, 4 Steps to Building Your Future, Kaplan 2009. Dan is a founding member of the Young Entrepreneur Council and writes syndicated media columns that are seen by more than 1.2 million readers biweekly. He has written articles for a variety of other print and online publications, including the Wall Street Journal, Entrepreneur, Brand Week, Mashable, AOL Jobs, Yahoo, Shine, MediaPost, BNET, and Advertising Age. As a national speaker, Dan has spoken to high-profile corporations such as IBM, Citigroup, Time Warner, Harvard Business School, and MIT, and is exclusively represented by the Big Speak, Inc. Speakers Bureau. Dan helps individuals and companies with creative branding solutions. How Dan's big vision has evolved, in his own words. When I first started out, I referred to myself as the personal branding spokesperson for Gen Y. I was careful not to use the word expert because I was only writing about the subject on personalbrandingblog.com at that point. After 6 months of hard work, and after establishing a magazine, online TV show, awards, and published articles, the magazine Fast Company profiled me. This led to Google asking me to speak at their campus and my current company, hiring me to be the first social media specialist. It proved my theories about personal branding, and thus I rebranded myself as the personal branding expert for Gen Y. I eventually wrote my book, which is entitled Me 2.0 and targeted at Gen Y, but read by other generations. I officially launched my company in January 2010, and my vision has changed quite a bit since then. My firm is a full-service personal branding agency whose mission is to inform and educate professionals on the importance of personal branding so they can achieve career success and happiness in their own lives. The association my name has with personal branding has helped me tremendously in becoming top of mind in this field. How Dan's unwavering vision has fueled his success. I can honestly say that I've never doubted myself when it comes to personal branding. I firmly believe that I was born to be doing what I'm doing now, which gives me confidence and alleviates any fear. I've been rejected and ignored so many times at this point that it doesn't even bother me. When you're confident about your product, you don't worry about failure. The importance of having a big vision from the start. A big vision gives you a point on which to focus to create short-term, measurable goals. I always tell clients that you need to start with the end goal in mind if you want to take steps today to reach it. Brand yourself for the career you want, not the job you currently have. If you can't envision the end product before you start creating it, you don't know what you will end up with. You will waste a lot of resources, time, and money if you don't know the exact product you want to develop. My greatest talent is being able to take a vision, turn it into a realistic model, and then execute on it. A big vision also gets both me and my team excited about the journey we're taking toward success and accomplishment. Dan's advice for entrepreneurs interested in starting a company from the ground up. Entrepreneurs who are starting a company from scratch should base their business on something they truly love. It's the only way you're going to work hard enough to reach your big vision. It's easy to give up and quit on a business that you're just doing for the money. Try to use the least amount of capital possible when you first start, because it will allow you to survive the first year. And finally, it's vital to surround yourself with people who can complement your skill set and who you can trust. How Dan defines success. Success means putting yourself in a position that allows you to monetize your passion. You will be happy if you're making money doing what you love, regardless of how much money that is. True success comes when you wake up each day with the freedom and flexibility to do what you want, when you want, and how you want to do it. I feel like I'm in control of my own destiny, and that I positively change other people's lives as well. Fuel your fire with passion and perseverance. Though an initial spark is an essential ingredient, there is much more to being a successful entrepreneur than having and maintaining that vision. The unfortunate reality is that there are plenty of people who have the big vision moment, but who never become entrepreneurs, because they don't have the passion needed to sustain this vision long enough to take action. There are also people who get started, but who lack perseverance, and therefore falter when obstacles arise. Turning your initial vision into a viable business has everything to do with your level of passion and ability to keep moving forward, even in the face of challenges. Without passion, it is easy to become discouraged from pursuing your plans by other priorities and self-doubt when difficulties arise. Your mindset ultimately dictates your actions, so operating with one that is anything less than dedicated unwaveringly to your future as a business owner will cause you to struggle to take the actions necessary for your success. Every entrepreneur in the world comes up against challenges in his or her business. No matter how carefully you plan, no matter how great you are at what you do, and no matter how hard you try to make sure everything always goes smoothly, unexpected trials will test your vision. The many successful entrepreneurs we've interviewed from a variety of industry sectors, backgrounds, and areas of the world have almost all credited their perseverance as the most significant element of their success. They claim that their ability to maintain their vision and a positive mindset in the face of adversity has been the X factor that has made all the difference in their eventual achievement or failure. Their vision was big enough to carry them through the hard times, so it overshadowed any doubt that crept in along the way. In fact, these kinds of challenges are exactly what cause many entrepreneurs to thrive. But even the most formidable entrepreneurial spirits aren't immune to discouragement and disappointment. We all struggle at times to maintain our positive mindset and to stay true to our initial vision. Fortunately, we can use unexpected setbacks and problems as opportunities and learning experiences, and we can push through just about anything. But let's be realistic. There isn't a person on the planet who doesn't, at some time, have doubts or worries about themselves or their business. It would be unnatural to never feel discouraged or frustrated. The key is to keep those feelings from ruining your vision and changing your mindset. During the worst times, we can all use some help to persevere and stay the course. To that end, we present 5 keys for maintaining your vision and positive mindset. 1. Plan your work and work your plan. Entrepreneurs commonly become discouraged by a sense of being overwhelmed. This is particularly true within startup companies or those experiencing a period of sudden growth. Although the startup process can be an exciting, energizing time, and although growth is almost always a great thing, the pressure to get so much done in a short amount of time can mount and incite feelings of frustration and worry. In companies where deadlines are the norm, these feelings might not ever ease up. In fact, regardless of company structure, we can all occasionally feel like there just isn't enough time in a day to get everything done that needs to be done. So, how do you keep from losing sight of your vision when this happens? One way to avoid, or at least reduce, the pressures that can dampen your entrepreneurial spirit is to stick to a plan as closely as possible. This isn't your business plan. Rather, it's about a daily action plan that keeps you focused, not only on the details of your day, but on the big picture as well. A great way to devise such a plan is to ask yourself what you have to do daily to achieve your long-term objectives. Once you've answered that question, design your daily plan around those activities and delegate or hire others to perform as many of the other tasks as possible. There are some significant advantages to this tactic. First, chances are good that the duties you end up tackling will be those that have to do with building and growing your business. If you're in a business that you love, which is hopefully the case, you'll enjoy the activities that contribute most to the company's success. And it doesn't really feel like work when you're doing what you love to do, even if you have a ton on your plate, and you're far less likely to become overwhelmed. Additionally, working from a plan of action gets a lot of your to-do items out of your head and down on paper or on a computer screen. You know what your responsibilities are and can focus on one thing at a time without all the other issues weighing on your mind. Of course, even when you have a plan, you'll need to deal with some unexpected fires that come up. When these challenges arise, the key is to handle them as quickly and efficiently as possible, with the goal of getting back on the plan as soon as you can. Your plan can be flexible, but only to the extent that it continually supports your long-term vision. 2. Guard against negativity, from outside and within. No matter how intense your initial spark was, it simply isn't possible to maintain it for long if you're deluged with negativity and cynicism. This can be a difficult challenge to overcome at times, because it is often those closest to us, friends, family, and coworkers, who are the ones feeding us negative energy. This may especially be the case if you don't come from a family or peer group of entrepreneurs. You're more likely to receive a lot of pushback from those around you, and you might even feel some resentment as you experience success. You can take steps to effectively offset any negativity you're experiencing, either from other people or from yourself. First and foremost, it's important to think for yourself and stay focused on your business and your dreams. You should certainly be open to others' feedback and criticism, but only take actual advice from those who have done what you want to do. People with whom you discuss your business idea frequently act like experts, even though they have never successfully created their own company. Just remember that the person with whom you're talking probably isn't qualified to advise you unless he or she has accomplished what you want to accomplish. Their hearts might be in the right place, but always take what they say with a grain of salt. Surround yourself with positive people as often and for as long as possible. Attend networking events. Get to know other entrepreneurs in your community. Schedule lunch with a high-energy peer to have an inspired discussion about the future. Prioritize your time so that for every hour you spend around people who are negative, you spend 2 hours around people who get it and who can feed you positive energy. 3. Fortify your mind. Our culture's self-improvement movement has been in full swing for more than 35 years now, and enough material has come out of it to keep you surrounded by positive words for the rest of your life. An Amazon search for the term self-improvement yields more than 60,000 books, not to mention thousands of DVDs and audio programs in MP3 format and on CD. If this isn't enough, you can find countless seminars, retreats, workshops, and camps, all designed to infuse your mind with positive energy and purpose. On top of that, you have the option to hire a business or personal coach to keep you focused on your vision. Instead of watching the news, or almost any TV for that matter, listen to an audiobook or watch a YouTube video of inspirational speakers like Les Brown or Tony Robbins. You have an opportunity to control what goes into your mind. Choose to focus on positive, uplifting, and motivating material to help you overcome obstacles more easily, to ignore the negativity of the world around you, and to keep your vision alive and strong. 4. Embrace change. It's been said that the only thing you can count on never changing is the fact that everything changes. You can plan for every contingency imaginable, and the unexpected is still bound to arise at some point. It is simply the nature of business and life. Whether it's an economic downturn, an unexpected product shortage, or new technology that changes the face of your industry, something will happen sooner or later for which you didn't and couldn't plan. Often, the difference between thriving and feeling overwhelmed in such times of change is the ability to embrace the change and make it work for you, rather than feeling crushed when things don't go as planned.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.